killed you. Me money didn't alarm. Quick, Duckworth, get the limo.
I shall not. Get out in gear, sir.
Honey, Duckworth, honey!
The pedal is to the metal, Mr. McDonald.
We're the Beagle Boys again. They can stand between Scrooge McDuck and his 3 cubic acres of cash. They've got another thing coming.
Away from him, you gluttonous goon!
Sorry, Scroogey. Not a chance.
You saved me, Uncle Scrooge!
I did. Oh, you hurt a lot.
I'll handle this.
Thank you. this is me.
Free in a jiffy.
Not so fast, McDuff. We're running things around here now.
Cussed it, children. One false move and I'm a roast duck.
Leave me, a Scrooge. It's not worth it.
Nonsense, my boy.
You'll never beat us, Scrooge.
Lot of good that'll do us if they make it to me vault. Fortune, you crook.
Not this time, McDuck. Oh, you ain't getting the drop on this big old boy.
Safe is securely suspended.
I'm gonna get you.
There you are, sir.
My aching head.
Everything is ready, sir. Everything is ready, sir.
Good riddance to bad beagles, I say. Now, why in the world was he interested in this old painting? Surely there are more valuable. Well, pluck me, pin feathers. It looks like some kind of secret code. Boys, boys!
What did you find, Uncle Scrooge? Yeah, what is it?
I'm not sure, but I know how to find it out. I'll feed it into my supercomputer and use Gyro's new crypto-analysis program. Then we'll know what the Beagle Boys were after. Stand back, lads. Brigadoon!
What is it, Uncle Scrooge?
It's a treasure map, lads. And no ordinary treasure by the look of things.
Only Uncle Scrooge would call any kind of treasure ordinary. You! One of the treasures is in the middle of the Amazon. And there's another one in Transylvania. And one buried 10 miles underground. Hey, wait a minute. Something's screwy. This last treasure can't be right. Yeah, there's no mountain on earth that's that high. Well, according to the Junior Woodchuck Guide, to get there we have to take about 537 million steps straight up till we reach the moon. You mean the moon, moon?
It looks that way, lads. Well, what are we waiting for? That treasure's no going to discover itself. Get Launchpad on the horn. I'm headed to the Amazon jungle to find the scepter of the Incan King. Thanks for the lift, launch pad.
No problemo. Lift is one of my favorite principles of aerodynamics. Oh, say, you got your radio, Mr. McDee?
Hey, of course I do.
Great! Then I'll be your eyes in the sky.
Oh, I'd be happy if you just keep your eyes on the sky for once. What an airhead.
Hey, I heard that.
Now then, ancient Incan legends claim the king's scepter was locked away in a giant temple of the clouds, and it should be dead ahead.
Gee, Mr. McDee, I see a lot of clouds, but no temple.
You wouldn't, Launchpad. The legend says the temple was hidden away from all but King Manco Capquack himself. But there's bound to be a way to reveal it buried somewhere in this overgrown salad bowl, and I'm not leaving till I find it. Depicting a nightingale.
Hello. You haven't stumbled across a pizza joint down there, have you, Mr. McDee? You're getting kind of hungry up here.
I'm not even going to dignify that question with a response.
I've never seen a gem like this before.
Bearing the image of the Queen's horse. It'll help us find the treasure for sure.
How can you tell, boss?
Never doubt the well-honed instincts of an experienced treasure hunter.
If you say so, Mr. McDee.
Thank you. A coin joined the sun. Get I nearly tripped over it. This place is a mess. Where's Mrs. Bigley when you need her? Image of a scythe. It must represent a good harvest.
This is Lunchpad, calling Mr. McDee.
What is it, Lunchpad?
I'm running a little low on fuel up here.
Well, where are the extra fuel canisters?
That's why I'm calling you, boss. I checked the glove compartment, but I found those gloves.
You'd best find those fuel canisters, for the next thing you'll be flying is a model airplane.
Is that a promise?
Found another one! And it depicts the ruling might of a spear.
This is Launchpad, Mr. McDee! Come in, Mr. McDee!
Launchpad, what was that? Shows a shield. You know, I bet those Inkans could have minted a whole lot more coins if they hadn't tried to make each one unique. The scales of justice. Just what I need to help me find the scepter.
You know, Mr. McDee, I had a thought.
Launchpad, why start now and spoil a perfect record?
That's a good question.
Well, I don't have all day. What was your thought?
Come to think of it, I forgot.
Launchpad, were you dropped on your head much as a child?
All the time. Why?
I found something. There's a carving of Mongol Kufquak on this stone slab, and there's 8 circular notches around it.
Sounds great. Does it tell us how to find the treasure?
Well, I'm not sure what it tells us, but I'm certain it's an important clue. Bless me, bagpipes. These coins I found will fit perfectly into those notches.
Oh, you must have come across an ancient Incan poker table, Mr. McDee. How about I come down there and you deal me in for a hand?
You come down here and I'll deal you a blow to the head. You're supposed to be keeping an eye out for trouble, remember? Launchpad, what if the images on these coins symbolize the various tribes of Mongol Kapwak's empire? Maybe if I surround him with them. Oh no, it's not working.
Hey, maybe you need to say the magic words. Or maybe not.
Will you look at that? The ancient city of Mongol Kufquak. And that beam of light. It must be pointing to the Temple of the Clouds. But how am I going to get across?
Up here, Mr. McDee.
Temple of Mongol Kufquak.
With a little help from your old pal, Launchpad McQuack.
Oh, of course, Launchpad. I couldn't have done it without you. Now just hold on, and with a little luck, that scepter will be mine in no time. Now, where did you come from?
Why, from home, of course. I had to be sure you were all right in this filthy place.
You're worth your weight in gold, Mrs. Beakley. If you'll pardon the expression.
Oh, of course. But I'll find my own way out, thank you very much.
There it is, the king's scepter. Well, oh, this was easier to find than a penny in a parking lot.
Catch me, Kilts! What was that?
Foretold that our ancient city would one day be returned to us. For hundreds of years we have waited, and at last that day has come.
You mean you're not mad at me?
Mad? Quite contrary, Featherborn. Is there anything we can do to repay you?
Well, now that you mention it, I did come here looking for an ancient scepter. I didn't suppose...
Does it? This? It fell from the temple.
Oh, they're climbing for nothing, eh, Mr. McDee?
Bless me, bagpipes, the scepter of the Incan King!
It is yours. Take it and go in peace. After all, it was just the old king's back scratcher.
Tell you boys, there's something special about this treasure.
Really, Uncle Scrooge?
Yeah, it just looks like an old back scratcher does.
You boys need to learn some respect for the finer things in life. Now, if you're done having fun at your old uncle's expense, help me decide where we should go next. your bags, boys. We're off to Transylvania, and we've no coming back without the coin of the Lost Realm. This is it, kids. Dracula Manor, home of the legendary Great One Gladstone, heir to the coin of the Lost Realm.
Boy, it's kind of creepy out here, isn't it? Uncle Scrooge, we're not going to break into this guy's house, are we?
Yeah, of course not, Louie. This castle has been abandoned for centuries.
Hey, look at this. The Junior Woodchuck Guidebook says Drake von Gladstone, best known by his nickname, Count Dracula Duck. Is there really a monster in there, Uncle Scrooge? Aw, don't be silly, Webby. Yeah, there's no such thing as Dracula. Right! He is right, isn't he, Uncle Scrooge?
Of course he is, Louie. Vampires, banshees, and mischievous spirits are just a lot of superstitious hocus-pocus. But you better stick close to me, just in case. Stay put and keep an eye on Wee Riverdale. I'll be back with the treasure in no time.
Aw, nuts! We want to come with you, Uncle Scrooge!
Don't worry. I'll be back with the coin before you can say E Pluribus Unum.
E Pluribus Unum? Yeah, I'm not sure that's as fast as I think it is. Besides, why should we have to stay here just because Webby's a big chicken? Yeah! We're not afraid of... whatever's hiding out there, you boys are so mean. I'll show you who's not afraid of the dark. We're ready! Oh no!
Huey! Louie!
Will they be alright, Uncle Scrooge?
Of course. Everything will be fine, my darling. Wait here, and I'll be back with the lads lickety-split. trying to beat me to my treasure, no doubt. But it'll take more than just an old bedsheet and flower dust to frighten off Scrooge McDuck.
Look, Uncle Scrooge, that eagle boy dropped something. It's an old piece of paper.
Twist me, Tom. It's an ancient rune.
You mean like a magic spell?
Aye, lad. At least part of one.
Gee, I wonder who tore it into pieces.
We'll worry about that later. Right now, I want you to head to the front door and wait for me. I'll be back once I've found the treasure. Off you go, lad. Scrapping with Scrooge McDuck.
Speaking of scraps, he dropped this up on Scrooge.
It looks like another piece of that drawn up sorcery.
Say what?
A magic spell. And it's nearly complete. Just one piece left to find. If only I knew where to start looking.
Well, that Bungle Boy did say this house had an illusion wall. Do you think he meant?
Of course, a secret passage. Oh, no wonder I've been having so much trouble finding anything around here. Good lad. Now, off you go. I need you to wait at the entrance with the others. This part of the spell matches the inscriptions on this mirror. Oh, if only I had all the pieces to this puzzle. not so tough without your army helmet, eh?
Only the gang in Sing Sing finds out you were not flat by an old guy in his cane.
thank you, lad.
Yeah? Well, you better be careful where you go poking around, McDuck, or you's gonna have much bigger problems than me. So long.
Now, what do you suppose he meant by that? Oh, it doesn't matter. Quick, lad, see if there's a scrap of paper lying about.
You mean like this one, Uncle Scrooge?
Exactly. This is the last piece of the riddle.
What to do?
That's what I'm about to find out. Quick, lad, go meet Webby and the others at the entrance. And all of you, stay put. Is that you?
It most certainly is. Why, just look at all these cobwebs. This place could use a woman's touch.
You're worth your weight in gold, Mrs. Bigley. If you'll pardon the expression.
Oh, of course. But I'll find my own way out, thank you very much.
I've still got it. one. One dozen two.
Ducks! I saw the riddle!
What riddle, Uncle Scrooge?
Boys, I thought I told you to stay with Webby.
They did stay with me, Uncle Scrooge. I'm right here. Oh, what a pretty mirror.
Aye, lass. And if I'm right, using this spell will reveal the foul perpetrator behind all these shenanigans. Dispel. Oh, I should have known you'd be behind this.
Oh, Scroogey, my old friend. You wouldn't believe how much fun it is watching you run around making a fool of yourself.
What?
Oh, you really don't think you need ancient sorcery to find coin with Lost Realm, do you?
No, I have Beetle Boy's high paper scrap to throw you off trail.
Why, you sneaky, conniving...
Please! Save compliments for garden party.
What garden party?
The one I will throw in celebration when I get home. With lost coin. So long, fool!
she is very nice. You said it, Webby.
All right, you kids stay here. I'm going to track down that witch and give her a piece of my mind.
your mirror and beam spells. It's the last time I shop for spell ingredients at this town store. You haven't seen lots of magic at the spell. You may have coin of lost realm, but your number one guide will soon be mine.
Like her have a way of popping up at the most inconvenient moments.
Well, when it comes to Magicka, there's no such thing as a convenient moment.
Too true, Louie. Now then, where to next, lads?